Lieutenant Pete Sanchez, S-A-N-C-H-E-Z, City of Miami Fire Rescue. Just before 2:30 this morning, we received a 911 call that there was two boats on fire at a marina located off the Miami River. When we arrived on the scene, we encountered two large yacht vessels that were completely engulfed. One is about 70 feet or larger, and the other one's about 50 feet. We immediately started a hazardous operations team operation with foam, and we also requested our fireboat to assist us on the river. We also had ladders on the bridge extinguishing the flames from above. We had about 17 units on the scene, and it took about an hour to get this blaze under control. We are still on the scene extinguishing some hot spots. We cannot confirm if there was anyone on board at this time. We have not been able to locate an owner or an owner of the marina. At this time, our fire investigator is on the scene. He will determine what the origin and cause of the fire was this evening.
What are some of the difficulties you face in fighting fires like this?
The conditions were intense. That's why we had multiple units from the bridge, from the water and land. It also, you're dealing with a lot of fuel, a lot of plastics. So we also had to use a foam operation. That's why our hazardous materials team was here. We were also able to untie and relocate two other large vessels from getting damaged. So the fire was actually isolated to the two yachts, and the damage is pretty extensive. So like I said, one has to be at least above 70 feet and the other one has to be above 50 feet.
And you said, no injuries, but you said something about being able to locate.
Right now we cannot report any injuries, but we can't locate the owners. We have not been able to locate the owners of the boat or the owners of this marina. So we can't confirm that there was no one on board, but from what we see and from what we know, we have no injuries reported.
And you were saying the building over there, the marina, there's like no sign, no address. There's a sign that says like permanently closed.
Correct. We're looking for the address of the building. We were trying to locate the owner, which we haven't been able to. We do have an address, but we don't have a name of the property right now.
There's no chance nothing exploded or anything while you guys were working this, right?
Right now it was controlled. It was a large fire, but it was controlled and it was isolated to those two boats. We didn't get any reports of any explosions, just a lot of heavy flames and heavy smoke, as you see.
What are your concerns, like environmentally, if it goes into the, obviously goes into the water, the gas and all that,
The foam blankets are pretty good to protect that and to isolate the fuels, and that's why we use foam for these type of fires, to be able to isolate it and contain it to the area that it's in.
Did that bigger freighter get a fire damage as well?
No, that freighter's been there up against the bridge for quite some time, so it was not related to the incident.
Thank you.
Thank you. behind the fireboat.
About 33 times out of here, that's off the 14 and 8 Street, off the 14 and 8 Street, it's 10 by overdrive.
Go!
Good job.